Darren's our in-house master leather worker, so he specialises in all of our leather work.
His specialty is hand-tooled leather armour, and that meant that this production could not have been more rewarding for him, and probably in equal parts challenging.
For the character Mulan, we created three different types of armour. We created her father's armour, her infantry armour, and then that armour is stripped off to just the tassets to be her final look.
My role particularly was to manufacture the father's armour, which is a unique type of standalone armour in this movie.
We've not had the opportunity to work on this design aesthetic before. This traditional Chinese lamellar armour look is something that's so unique.
Knowing the techniques needed to produce this type of Chinese armour required Darin solving some pretty complex problems.
One of our biggest challenges whenever we make a suit of armour is embracing both the form and function of the outfit. It has to look realistic and robust, but at the same time has to facilitate action movements.
The costume designer Bina Diagella came down to Wellington and worked with our team, especially through the prototyping phase.
Bina had a great vision for the father's armour, but she also had a great understanding of costume. It was an incredible opportunity to work with her. One of the great stages of the process of manufacturing costumes is when you finally get to try it on the actor and everyone is able to appreciate the result of many months of hard work. Yifei, once she put the armour on, seemed to start to embody the role, and you could see the light in her eyes, and she was just like, give me a sword, you know, I need to do something, you know. She was like really sort of encouraged by what we'd made for her.
I know that Darin is very proud of the work that he did on Mulan, and the armour that he produced was just, to me, really beautiful.